Good morning, dear students. We have started with the lesson, the proposal. We have already learned that Dumo comes to ask for Chubuko's daughter's hand in marriage. And then Natalia and Lumo, they both start quarreling over their oxen meadows. Natalia says that those oxen meadows belong to her, while Lumo says that they belong to him. So Natalia doesn't believe Lumo saying that those oxen meadows belong to him. So now let's see what happens next. Lumo: but you can see from the documents, honored Natalia Stepanovna, oxen meadows, it's true, were once the subject of dispute, but now everybody knows that they are mine. There is nothing to argue about. You see, my aunt's grandmother gave the free use of these meadows in perpetuity to the peasants of your father's grandfather, in return for which they were to make bricks for her. The peasants belonging to your father's grandfather had the free use of the meadows for 40 years and had got into the habit of regarding them as their own. When it happened that perpetuity means a state of lasting forever. Lumo mentions, he says that he has the proof that those oxen meadows belong to him. He has certain documents which can prove that those oxen meadows belong to him. He also says that once those meadows were disputed property, there was some sort of dispute regarding that oxen meadows, but now the dispute is solved and now those meadows belong to him. So he talks about the history. He remembers the history and he tells Natalia that his aunt's grandmother had given the free use of those meadows to the peasants of her father's grandfather. For 40 years, those peasants worked in those meadows. So as they worked there for 40 years, they started claiming that the oxen meadows belong to them. Natalia: no, it isn't at all like that. Both grandfather and great-grandfather reckoned that their land extended to burnt marsh. I don't see what there is to argue about. It's simply silly. Reckoned means established by calculation. Natalia disagrees to what Lumo had said. She says that since childhood, she has heard from her grandfather and their great-grandfather that their land extended up to the burnt marsh. She had complete trust on her grandfather and great-grandfather. So she doesn't feel any point in arguing about the ownership of those meadows. She completely believes that those meadows belong to her. Lumo: I'll show you the documents, Natalia Stepanovna. So Lumo tells Natalia that he can show her the documents which prove that those oxen meadows belong to him. Natalia: no, you are simply joking or making fun of me. What a surprise. We have had the land of nearly 300 years and then we are suddenly told that it isn't ours. Ivan Vasilevich, I can hardly believe my own ears. These meadows aren't worth much to me. They only come to 5 dessiatins and are worth perhaps 300 rubles. But I can't stand unfairness. Say what you will, I can't stand unfairness. Now, Natalia thinks that Lumo is making fun of it. He is just joking. Because she believes that this land is their property since last 300 years. And now somebody has come and has claimed for that land. Actually, the land was not too costly. It was just 300 rubles. But Natalia is very much disappointed by unfairness. She thinks that Lumo is unfair with her, and so she is very much disappointed. Lumo, hear me out, I implore you. The peasants of your father's grandfather, as I have already had the honor of explaining to you, used to bake bricks for my aunt's grandmother. Now, my aunt's grandmother, wishing to make them a pleasant, implore means to beg someone to do something. Now Lumo begs Natalia, please, please, please listen to me what I have to say. So he begs her to listen to him. He tells that her great grandfather's peasants used to bake bricks in that meadows for his aunt's grandmother. And he keeps on talking, but as he continues talking, he is interrupted by Natalia. I can't make head or tail of all this about aunts and grandfathers and grandmothers. The meadows are ours, that's all. Now Natalia is not ready to listen anything about the meadows. So she interrupts in the middle. She just knows one thing, that those meadows belong to her. She doesn't want to talk about their grandmother or grandfather or great grandmother or aunt. Lumo, mine. So Lumo says that those meadows belong to him. Natalia, ours. You can go on proving it for 2 days or on end. You can go on proving it for 2 days on end. You can go and put on 15 dress jackets. But I tell you, they are ours, ours, ours. I don't want anything of yours and I don't want to give anything of mine. So there. So Natalia says that Lumo can do anything to prove whatever he has said. Or he can even wear 15 such jackets as he was wearing that day. So here, wear 15 jackets. Here she wants to say that even Lumo was well dressed. He was not, Natalia was not influenced by it. So she has no influence about his dress. Even if he does anything, Natalia won't accept that those meadows belong to him. She also tells Lumo that she doesn't want anything from him, and also she won't give anything to him which belongs to her. Not even the oxen meadows. She says that those are oxen meadows belong to her. Lumo, Natalia Stepanovna, I don't want the meadows, but I am acting on principle. If you like, I'll make you a present of them. So Lumo says that even there is no value of those oxen meadows for him, but he says that he is fair enough and he is acting on his principle. He is following his principle. He also offered to make a present of those oxen meadows to her. He said that he would give those oxen meadows as a gift to Natalia. Natalia, I can make you a present of them myself because they are mine. Your behavior, Ivan Vasilievich, is strange to say the least. Up to this, we have always thought of you as a good neighbor, a friend. Last year, we lent you our threshing machine, although on that account, we had to put off our own threshing till November. But you behaved to us as if we were gypsies, giving me my own land indeed. No, really, that's not at all neighborly. In my opinion, it's even impudent if you want to know. Now, gypsies means a nomadic people who travel from one place to another. And impudent means not showing due respect to other person, one who doesn't have respect for other person. So when Lomo says that I can give those meadows as a gift to you, Natalia says that she also can make a present of it to him because those meadows belong to her. She's also surprised that how Lomo is offering her own property as a gift to her. She feels that that is her property, and how could other person gift her own property. She also says that he has been acting very strange till now. She says that they had thought him as a friendly neighbor, but his behavior doesn't show any kind of neighborhood. Last year, Natalia's family had offered him threshing machine, and they delayed their own work by giving the threshing machine to Lomo. But he had been treating Natalia's family oddly. She feels that Lomo is not showing due respect to her and her family. Lomo. Then you make out that I am a land grabber. Madam, never in my life have I grabbed anybody else's land, and I shan't allow anybody to accuse me of having done so. Now Lomo feels as if Natalia is trying to say that he has grabbed their land. He feels offended, and he says that never in his life he had grabbed anyone's property, anyone's land. He has never taken anything which does not belong to him. And he also cannot tolerate anyone accusing him for that. While sipping on some water, he tells that oxen meadows belong to him. Natalia, it's not true. They are ours. Lomo, mine. Natalia still insists that the oxen meadows are there. Lomo is stuck to his view. He says that those oxen meadows belong to me. Natalia, it's not true. I'll prove it. I'll send my movers out to the meadows this very day. A mover means a person who cuts grass with mower. Now Natalia feels that she should prove her ownership, and so she decides to send grass cutters at the location, that is in the oxen meadows, that day itself. Lomo, what? Natalia, my movers will be there this very day. Now Lomo doesn't believe what Natalia says, but Natalia insists. She says that her grass cutters will be there on that day itself. Lomo, I'll give it to them in the neck. Natalia, you dare. So Lomo says that he will hit those grass cutters who will come to his meadows to cut the grass. Natalia says that he should not dare to do such type of thing. Lumo. Oxen meadows are mine, you understand, mine. Natalia. Please don't shout. You can shout yourself hoarse in your own house, but here I must ask you to restrain yourself. Now, Lumo becomes very aggressive and he starts speaking loudly. In his loud voice, he says that the oxen meadows are his and only his. Hoarse means sounding rough and harsh. Restrain means prevent from doing something. So when Lumo starts shouting, when he raises his voice, Natalia asks him to behave properly. And she also asks him not to shout because he was in her house. She stops him from shouting loudly in her house. Lumo. If it wasn't, madam, for this awful excruciating palpitation, if my whole inside wasn't upset, I would talk to you in a different way. Yes, oxen meadows are mine. Excruciating means intensely painful, severe. Now here he mentions about his painful heartbeat. His heartbeat increased and he mentions about it. And for this increased heart rate, he blames his own tone. He blames his tone that as he has raised the tone, his heartbeats have increased. So even he is in pain, he doesn't stop saying that oxen meadows are his. Natalia asks, Lumo, mine. Natalia asks, Lumo, mine. Now in this way, they both keep on quarreling with each other over the oxen meadows. Chubuko, what's the matter? What are you shouting for? Now, on hearing both of them shouting, Natalia's father, Chubuko, enters. And he asks why they both were fighting with each other. Natalia, Papa, please tell this gentleman who owns oxen meadows, we or he? Chubuko, darling, the meadows are ours. Now Natalia tells her father, she asks her father to tell about the ownership of those meadows. She wanted to know exactly whom those meadows belong to. She wants to tell Lumo, she wants to give confirmation in front of Lumo regarding the ownership of those meadows. So Chubuko tells Lumo the same thing which Natalia has said, that the oxen meadows belong to them. Lumo, but please, Stepan Stepanovich, how can they be yours? Do be a reasonable man. My aunt's grandmother gave the meadows for the temporary and free use of your grandfather's peasants. The peasants used the land for 40 years and got accustomed to it as if it was their own when it happened that. So when Chubuko claims that the oxen meadows belong to them, Lumo questions him. He asks him to be reasonable. He explains to him the story of the oxen meadows. So while he is explaining the story, Chubuko interrupts him. Chubuko, excuse me, my precious. You forget just this, that the peasants didn't pay your grandmother and all that because the meadows were in dispute and so on. And now everybody knows that they are us. It means that you haven't seen the plan. So now here Chubuko interrupts and tells Lumo that those peasants, they worked freely in those meadows because of the only reason that it was a disputed land. He also says that now it is clear to everyone that those meadows belong to us. He also blames Lumo for not going through the plan, for not seeing the plan. Lumo, I'll prove to you that they are mine. Chubuku, you won't prove it, my darling. Lumo, I shall. So when Chubuku says that he had not seen the plan, Lumo says that he can prove that the oxen meadows are his. So Chubuku says that he can't prove it. So Lumo replies that he can. Chubuku, dear one, why yell like that? You won't prove anything just by yelling. I don't want anything of yours and don't intend to give up what I have. Why should I? And you know, my beloved, that if you propose to go on arguing about it, I much sooner give up the meadows to the peasants than to you there. So Chubuku says that, says to Lumo that he can't prove that meadows are his. He also tells him not to yell. Yell means shout loudly. He said that yelling wouldn't prove anything. By yelling, by raising the voice, you can't prove anything. He also says that he doesn't want anything which belongs to Lumo, and also he won't give anything to him which belongs to himself. He becomes very angry and he says Lumo that if he keeps on arguing, he will give those meadows to the peasants rather than Lumo. Lumo, I don't understand. How have you the right to give away somebody else's property? So Lumo says that he doesn't understand how anyone can give anyone else's property to somebody else. Means according to Lumo, the property was his, and how could Chubuku give that property to the peasants? Chubuku, you may take it that I know whether I have the right or not, because, young man, I am not used to being spoken to in that tone of voice and so on. I, young man, am twice your age and ask you to speak to me without agitating yourself and all that. Now, Chubuku gets irritated because of the high tone of Lumo. He says that he is twice his age and he deserves to be spoken in a low voice. He deserves to be spoken with respect, politeness and all that. Lumo, no, you just think I am a fool and want to have me on. You call my land yours and then you want me to talk to you calmly and politely? Good neighbors don't behave like that, Stepan Stepanovich. You are not a neighbor, you are a grabber. Now Lumo says that he is not talking politely because that Chubuku has been saying that the land is his. He is claiming Lumo's land as his own land, and because of that Lumo is speaking in an impolite way. He calls Chubuku a bad neighbor and also a grabber. He thinks that Chubuku has grabbed his land. Chubuku, what's that? What did you say? Natalia, Papa, send the movers out to the meadow at once. Chubuku, what did you say, sir? Natalia, oxen meadows are ours and I shan't give them to you. I shan't give them up, shan't give them up, shan't give them up. Now, Chubuku feels very disrespected and asks Lumo to repeat whatever he has said. So now Natalia interferes in middle and she asks her father Chubuko to send the mowers to the meadows. Now still Chubuko is unable to accept whatever Lumo has said, and so he asks again to repeat his words. Now Natalia here, she claims that the meadows are hers and she won't give it to anyone just because somebody is claiming for it. Lumo: well, see, I'll have the matter taken to court and then I'll show you. Now Lumo gets angry and he says that he would take the matter to the court and he would prove that he is the real owner of those oxen meadows. Chubuko: to court? You can take it to court and all that, you can. I know you. You are just on the lookout for a chance to go to court and all that. You pettifogger, all you people were like that, all of them. Now pettifogger means an inferior legal practitioner. A legal practitioner who is inferior, who is not superior, that is called as pettifogger. Now Chubuko says to Lumo that he is just looking for a chance to go to the court, just like all other people in his family. He told that he can go on with the proceedings. Lumo: never mind about my people. The Lumos have all been honorable people and not one has ever been tried for embezzlement like your grandfather. Embezzlement means theft. Now Lumo is also very angry and he refuses to listen anything against his family. He says that all the members of his family are respectable, unlike Chubuko's grandfather, who had been tried for theft or embezzlement, for misappropriation of funds. Chubuko: you Lumos have had lunacy in your family, all of you. Lunacy means a state of being lunatic. So Chubuko here mentions that insanity and irrationality runs in Lumos. Natalia: all. So Natalia also repeats after her father. Chubuko: your grandfather was a drunkard and your younger aunt Nastasya Mihailovna ran away with an architect and so on. Now Chubuko calls Lumo's grandfather as an alcoholic, as a drunkard who is addicted to drugs, and he breaks the news. He tells that Lumo's younger aunt ran away with an architect. Lumo: and your mother was humpbacked, something pulling in my side, my head held water. A hump means a round shape protuberance found as an abnormality on the back of a person, like you know that camel has a hump on its back. So similarly, a hump can be found on person's back as an abnormality. So here Lumo mentions that Chubuko's mother was humpbacked. It means she had a hump on her back. So while saying this, he felt a pull on his side and head. So he calls for help and asks for water. Chubuko: your father was a guzzling gambler. Now both were blaming each other's family. So as the game of blame was going on, Chubuko calls Lumo's father a guzzling gambler. Guzzling means greedy and gambler means one who gambles. So he calls Lumo's father a greedy gambler. Natalia: and there haven't been many backbiters to equal your aunt. So Natalia says that his aunt was a backbiter. Backbiter means one who speaks about the people behind them. So Natalia claims that Lumo's aunt was a backbiter. So in this way, they keep on quarreling. So that's it for today. We'll see the remaining part in our next class. Thank you.